I'm not clicking. Here are my hands. So that is as simple as it gets. Hi everyone, this is Anson from AnsonAlex.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you my favorite free auto clicker for Mac, and I'm going to give you a demonstration on how it works. Let's get into it. Okay, so the auto clicker that I like to use is the Murga auto clicker. It's just at Murga, MURGAA.com/auto-clicker-Mac. You can just Google it and you'll be able to find it if you search auto clicker with the Murga title. Now, I don't know that much about this developer and this company, but I do know that I've used it for a long time, almost for as long as I've used Mac. I've never had a problem with it. Pretty much all of the software is free. If it's not free, it comes with a free trial, and it seems like a pretty fair deal if you want to purchase it afterwards. But the one that I want to show you is free. So this is the one that I want to show you. Now, there's another one I'm going to show you at the end, and that's if you're looking for something a little bit more than an auto clicker. So you can kind of get an idea of what this looks like here on the website over here on the right, but let's go ahead and download it and install it and give it a demo run. So I'm just going to save it to my desktop. Once the zip file is downloaded, we can just click on it to open it up, and then we're going to navigate to our desktop. From the desktop, we can now go ahead and you should see this application that says Murga Auto Clicker.app. That came out when we double-clicked on the zip. We could delete the zip if we wanted to now. We just right-click and go ahead and move that to trash. And then we can double-click to open the auto-clicker. Now remember, this is an auto-clicker, so we do have to give it access to our input on our computer, so we're going to have to let it bypass certain Mac security things, but that's just what you need to do in order for an auto-clicker to work. So we're just going to click open here, and then on the license agreement, we can go ahead and we can read through it if we'd like, or go ahead and click accept. And you'll notice that the recorder is now open. Now, we'll test it out in a second, but I want to show you where those security options were, because I already did this on my computer, so it didn't pop up and require. But I'm going to show you that if you go into your settings and then go ahead and click on privacy and security, and from here, we're going to click on input monitoring. You'll notice that in input monitoring, we have the Murga auto clicker set to on, so it can monitor our inputs. Remember, this is dealing with mouse clicks, so it needs access to that part of the computer. So that's pretty normal. In addition to access to input monitoring, it also needs access, if we go back here, to accessibility. So still in privacy and security, but we're going to click on accessibility. And you'll notice that in here, we also have the Murga auto clicker enabled. If you have it enabled in those two areas, it should work on your computer. And if you're setting it up for the first time, it will walk you through and try and show you how you can enable that. But I wanted to show you where it is here if it's not working for some reason. And you should be able to go into your system settings right here into the privacy security section and just make sure it's enabled in those two areas. All right, now let's go ahead and let's give it a test run. Okay, so I've got the auto clicker open here on my desktop, and now we can take a look at all of the different options. So you'll notice that up here at the top, we can enter the maximum number of clicks that we'd like it to do. So if we want it to just go forever until we say stop, we want to make sure that is set to zero. Now we can set a delay between clicks if we'd like. So we could give it like a 1 second delay. We can delete the milliseconds. And you'll notice we have the option to display a menu in the status bar. So if we look up to the status bar, you'll notice we have this auto clicker up here. So you could disable that if you'd like to. If you want this box to be minimized when you start clicking, you can enable the minimize on start clicking option. Right here is where we could start and stop it, but we have a few other things to look at first, so hold that thought. We could also enable this option, which allows us to start and stop it with the middle mouse button. I like that because no matter where I am on the computer, I don't usually use that middle mouse button for much else. I can press that button and it can start or stop the auto clicker. If we scroll down a little bit, you can also determine a keyboard shortcut if you'd like to start and stop clicking. And so this is just a simple auto clicker that will allow you to just keep clicking at one point on the screen. There is another auto clicker that I'm going to show you in a little bit here that will allow you to, say, click at a certain point on the screen and then a few seconds later click at another point in the screen. But I wanted to show you the simple one first because I feel like people who just want that auto click don't want one that has all these other options that can be confusing. So this one is real simple. Let's test it out. Now, what do people use auto clickers for? Well, there can be different reasons, but more times than not, it's usually for some sort of game. So let's go ahead and let's open up Minecraft real quick and let's test our auto clicker. Okay, so here I am in a Minecraft game, and usually you would use this at like a spawner farm or something, but I'm just in a brand new game here, so we're in the snow. This was not a good example, but we're just going to use it. Let's just turn the auto clicker on and see if it works. So I'm just going to Command tab to the auto clicker, so it comes up over Minecraft here. And I've already, you know, enabled the middle mouse button to start, but in order for this to work the first time, I need to hit start. It won't actually work the first time. I figured that out while testing, but if we hit start,
press escape key to stop.
Press escape key that was serious. Anyway, we'll hit, oh, I just put my mouse over back to the game, and you'll notice it goes back into the game, and I'm not clicking. Here are my hands. And you'll notice that in the game, I'm continuously clicking in the same spot. So that is as simple as it gets, right? For an auto clicker. Now, if I press my middle mouse button, is it going to work? Ta-da, it stops clicking. Let me press the middle mouse button again. I get that weird voiceover again, and I start auto clicking again. Simple auto clicker. There you have it. Now, let me show you the advanced version. Notice that on this website for Merga, we could scroll all the way down to the bottom. You'll notice that you can click on this link that says Mac Automation. And they have a number of other Mac automation tools here as well. So we just looked at the auto clicker, but they also have a different auto clicker that's controllable using a shortcut key. This looks like even more simple. I like a few more options. That's why I showed you the other one. They have a random mouse clicker, so instead of just auto-clicking in the same spot, this will randomly click. Maybe you could even do some sort of art with that. I don't know. And then there's an auto keyboard, so this will automatically press certain buttons on your keyboard when you want. There's an auto typer. There's an auto talker. There's a mouse click counter. And then there is this last one, the Mac auto mouse click. And this is where you can put a whole list of actions together, as you can see here on the screen, of where you want your mouse to click, what type of click you want it to be, so left click, right click, middle click. Back in the old days, this was called a macro, right? For a game where you want to kind of just grind automatically without having to be there, you could use some sort of macro, some sort of auto clicker. Well, here you go. Mac auto mouse click is your tool. So this, in my opinion, is the best auto clicker for Mac, especially when it comes to the free versions. I hope you find this tool helpful, and I hope you found the video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.